Hey, in this video, I'm going to show you how you can basically make it appear that you've moved from one part of the room into another and have the color palette change for the room. The real thing I'm doing here is moving from the big room into the closet. I want it to look like all of a sudden it's dark. So this is basically showing how you can use exits in a way that's not moving from one room to some entirely different room, but within the same room, or at least appearing to the player that that's what's happening. So let's try and do that. First, I'm going to make a second room that looks just like this one. So I'll hit the duplicate button and I'll call this the closet. This one should have the darkness color palette. So what I want is to be here, and then when I cross the threshold into the closet, I want it to change to that color palette. So how can we do that? We just need to add an exit. Let's click here and add an exit, not a one-way exit, because I actually want the color palette to change when you enter the closet and when you exit. So I'll just do a regular exit. It's going from the exit, from the example room to the closet. So let's look at, first let's position these in the right place. So I'll click move here and just click there. I'll also click move here and add it to that same place. So you can see they're both here, but I want to make sure this is the closet. So there we go. There's the place where it's going to go. That's where you're going to end up. And I don't need any kind of transition effect. I want this to kind of be seamless, but I do want to have some kind of dialogue, at least just so that we can see how this could work. So when you're exiting from here, see this little star is the one that's highlighted. So that's what's happening down here. When you're exiting from here to the main room, I want it to say, who turned on the lights? And I will close that and then open this one. And when you leave here, I want to add narration that says, hey, it's dark in here. So let's see how this works. I'm going to hit play and let's see if we can make this happen. So I'll cross this threshold. It says, hey, it's dark in here. And now it looks like it's dark. And when I come out, it says, who turned on the lights? And it goes on. So hopefully that gives you a sense of how you can use exits to actually move between rooms that are just duplicates of each other so that it appears to the player that you're making something happen within the same room, even though it's two separate rooms.